Okay, we're gonna rig this now, and again, we're gonna cut the head off in a little bit of an angle to pony up good with the lead heads. I'm using a 3/8 ounce for my keel weighted one in the middle, and then 1/8 ounce for the sides, being that we're fishing that 8 to 15 foot of water range. And then get those good going right now. So this is my heavier one, my keel weight one. It's really important to thread that thing as straight as you can so that swim bait runs super straight, just like that. Okay, after my bigger one is, I'll just repeat the process, and you know, it's just really important to thread these swim baits on super straight so they swim straight. And then I'll repeat the process one more time. Right down the center, come out so you have three nice baits that are dead straight. It's gonna run true. Then at the top here, I like changing it up with different colors. I'm gonna try that light hitch color. This looks like some bigger bait are actually swimming after some smaller baits. So I use these little screw lock, owner makes them. They're little screw locks that you can't have a hook on it. So, and yeah, I don't wanna add any more lead to this rig. It's already heavy enough and swimming deep enough. So I'll just center punch it there and just turn it on. And it should thread down just like so. And I'll repeat that process one more time. And the neat thing about these, if this bait for some reason is swimming upside down, you just give a half turn on your corkscrew and you got it. So there's the rig. It's a little heavier weight in the center, sent right underneath here. And you could bend these wires any way you want, spread it out more for a slower retrieve, or actually turn it in a little bit for a deeper retrieve. But you know, you just constantly mess with these wires a little bit. Seem to last quite a long time, unless you hook it in a tree like I've done and lost a few of these rigs. But should be ready to go. Let's catch some fish.